say all the time. These are the clothes we wear every day. And my new book is about that. So the bit I'll read will tell you a little bit about that. People say the devil is in the details, but I contend that a great many angels reside there as well. For one thing, details distinguish cultures from one another and allow us to revel in the great diversity which the human race can manifest. All people have the same basic needs of food, shelter, and companionship, yet the ways we define and realize these things vary widely. One specific outlines of their needs defines not only their culture, but increasingly specific subsets thereof, narrowing down the identity which is truly their own. Shelter can be any structure from a palace to a yurt. Food may range from raw seaweed to roast woodland. As for companionship, it might take an entire network of acquaintances to stave off loneliness from one person, while another is happy nestled within a large family or cuddled close to the heart of one person who means the world. For some, all it takes is a single pet or a cherished book. These differences are details, it's true, but they're details that define us, and that we, in turn, define through our own choices and our resources. What distinguishes a Victorian home from a modern home? You've been hearing me all right?
Yes.
What distinguishes a Victorian home from a modern one? The answer is the same if one had asked what distinguishes any culture from another. Details. These details are too numerous to list, and most, on their own, might seem small to an outside observer. Yet each has a lesson to teach us. Just as each individual is a living part of his or her society. Just as hosting an exchange student teaches lessons about another culture, interacting with an artifact from history provides insights into another time. The effect is amplified when exposure intensifies. Many artifacts were designed to function within a specific context and interact with other objects and infrastructure contemporary to themselves.
You probably have to talk right into it.
I think you'll find if you bend it over further and stand further, you'll probably see more happens.
Well, the thing is, I'm too tall.
Let's try that. We're not used to microphones.
The more one can reinstate an artifact context, the better it functions and the more sense it makes.
Yeah.
Imagine trying to analyze a remote control without access to its corresponding device or the power sources of either. One of my favorite quotes about cultural meanings came from my first French professor on the very first day of class. "French people," she told the students, "don't say something in French because they mean it in English and just don't know any better. French people say something in French because they mean it in French." To truly comprehend the meaning of something, understanding its context is vital. Traveling to a foreign country is the best way to learn about its culture or language because it places the student in the context of the subject. They're exposed to all the details of life and witness how infinite factors compound each other to form the complex equation of a functioning society. We can't travel to the past, but we can surround ourselves with its details. From the time my husband and I first envisioned this project, living the way we do, we knew that this form of historical education would be a slow and steady work of a lifetime. Someone who is born into a culture emerges into a time and place already surrounded by its details. We would have to slowly reinstate them when this was possible, and compare and debate modern equivalents when it wasn't. For example, no publisher on earth will accept a handwritten manuscript anymore. I keep my daily diary by hand, as well as all my notes, and even draft my manuscripts that way. But when